Hi, I'm Ben Marriott. I make weekly motion design tutorials, and this week I'm going to break down my top 5 favorite plugins for After Effects. Let's begin. Alright, so these aren't your flashy plugins that will do all of the work and that you will instantly get a cool graphic as a result. I want to highlight the plugins that are actually useful in creating commercial work. They're not as sexy, but they are useful. To get some sexy free plugins, Saber and Orb from Video Copilot will show you a good time and leave you feeling empty afterwards. And I do have to give an honorable mention to Duik from Rainbox, which 100% deserves to be on this list, but I don't do an awful lot of character rigging in my work, and I haven't used it enough to give it an honest recommendation, but it's a crazy powerful rigging tool. Number 5, Text Evo, which is name your price on aescripts.com. This is by far the sexiest plugin of the bunch, and essentially it's a heavily simplified interface over here on the right for the text animator properties that you see if you dare delve deep enough down into this menu down here. And it just makes it really easy to apply those and tweak them. Now with our layer selected, it does have to be a text layer, we can go up here and choose whether we want to apply it to the animating in or the animating out of our text. Let's select in for now, click apply, which will add these effects and keyframes, and let's add an animation based on its position and based on its opacity. So just by clicking those buttons, we've now got this animation. Pretty cool for a few clicks. You can also select down here whether it's based on the letters, which it is now, or the words or the lines. I almost always choose lines and pretty much use it only in this combination. And over here in our effects panel, you can choose how many pixels the position wants to move in. You can delay certain elements and fiddle with it in a way a lot easier than going into the text animation properties. But be aware that relying on a plugin like this can be dangerous. Not fatal, but not far off. You might find that all of your text animations start to look the same because it's so easy to get a result like this. So just because it's easy doesn't mean it's the right way. But if you are on a tight deadline and something like this is going to be fine, I do recommend it. You can also do wacky stuff like this, but please don't. Number 4 is Butt Capper from Adam Plouffe, the plugin auteur behind Rubber Hose and Overlord, plugins that I use every day. And this is name your price on Gumroad and battleaxe.com. I love this because it is so specific, so specific, but really useful. So I've drawn a head here, and we've got the mouth drawn with a simple line from our pen tool, and at the moment it has these square ends to the line. If we want those to be round, we simply click over here, and bam, they're round. Want our eyes to have rounded edges? Bam, they're round. Our head, we click it, nothing happens. That's because these aren't the ends of the caps of a stroke. This is a complete shape. So if we hold Alt and click on this, we get round corners. Click on this style, we get the, you know, this style of corners. And back to a rectangle. I just find I use this all the time. Most of the time, I like my strokes rounded. And I find this plugin saves me so much time instead of having to navigate way down here and select all of these little triangles down here and then changing the cap down here. It's all done with one click. Two thumbs up. Number 3 is VC Vibrance, which is name your price on Video Copilot. It is an effect. They call it a plugin on the website. It might be a preset. I'm not sure. But it can do two things amazingly well. The first thing is recolor desaturated objects. So we type in Vibrance up here and add it. We can see that already it's changed that gray fire to this lovely green fire. And we can change the color up here with this eyedropper tool and select any color we like. And we can control the levels of luminance that it preserves, its vibrance, the amount of gamma as well. Loads of awesome stuff. It's great for compositing and maintaining the brightness of something when you change the color. But I mainly use this plugin for its matte alpha effect. At the moment it's selected off, but if we change this to on, you'll see that it removes all of the black from this image. If you get rid of the background and turn our transparency on, you can see that this sort of main fire shape is all that's left in the alpha channel. And this is an excellent alternative to using blending modes when something doesn't work exactly right or you don't want it to get too muddy. I use this a lot for textures, so I've got this texture layer here, and if we add VC Vibrance, we can change the matte alpha to only, so it's not going to recolor it. And here we can see the visible blue background, and only these sort of white areas are visible, similar to the screen blending mode. But now we can add a fill effect, and here we can change the color of what's left in the alpha channel, and get some results that simply changing the blending mode just doesn't allow. Number two is Ease Copy, which is name your price on AE Script. And this plugin has been so useful to me ever since I discovered it. Now this plugin does exactly what it promises from its name. It allows you to copy the easing influence values from one, two, or more keyframes and paste them onto other keyframes and even other properties. So say we've got this swell animation of a little square bouncing up with its scale property. And we've gone to all the trouble of animating all these keyframes in the graph editor and getting a nice lovely curve, and it's all looking good. And we want to match the timing to an animation of another property, maybe the position of this pentagon over here. So let's make a position keyframe down here, add a keyframe up here, another one, and one more. And at the moment it's all linear and doesn't match up anywhere close to our square, so we can easily select our scale keyframes from our square, select copy, select the keyframes from our pentagon, click on paste ease over here, and if we play them back, they're both in sync. This is really handy for getting your timing on your animations tight. And then of course you can offset them to create some different effects, but this is really useful. And number one, you probably guessed it, is FX Console, which is free from Video Copilot. Ever since this came out, every motion designer I know loves it and wants to marry it. Now on paper, this sounds like just an effect search bar from what's up here, but it's a lot more than that. So with a layer or a comp selected, you can press a keyboard shortcut. I've got it as Command Space, which is the default, and it will open up this little toolbar wherever your cursor is. And then you can simply start typing in an effect, and it will bring up all the effects under there, and simply apply it with one click. Gone are the days where you would have to physically move your mouse over to the effects preset and click down and press the effects like a Neanderthal. Now you can simply press a shortcut and type them in like Edgar Wilde would do. You also have space down here to select your favorite effect. So I've got a fill and curves on mine at the moment, so you can simply click those with one click and quickly start to build up your animation from effects at your fingertips. Another great thing about FX Console is when you open it up, you have this export button here, and when you click, you can either save what's in your composition window as a PNG or copy to the clipboard. We can easily open up Photoshop and paste it in. I find this great for presentation decks or making simple adjustments to style frames or, you know, making your YouTube thumbnails. I use this all the time and it's just damn good time all around. It's free, it'll save you time, you won't regret it. Please let me know down in the comments what other free plugins you love and use all the time. I'd love to know. Hopefully there's some I have never even heard of and that I get to use. And please don't forget to subscribe, hit that bell icon, like, and share.